Hello class, welcome you once again. We will see our part number 2 of the lesson 1.3 on Wings of Courage. Now we will start with question number 6. For his role in successfully leading the squadron in combat, he was awarded the Distinguished Flying Cross, DFC, in 1944. We have seen already in previous passages. On August 15, 1947, that is our Independence Day, he achieved the unique honor of leading fly past of over 100 IF aircraft over the Red Fort in Delhi. Now you can imagine what kind of achievement he has done. India gained independence on same day and he was flying IF aircraft on the Red Fort in Delhi. Say it is a huge moment for our Indians, and on that day he has got opportunity to fly the aircraft over the Red Fort. After his promotion to the rank of wing commander, he attended the Royal Staff College at the UK, it means United Kingdom, England. Immediately after the Indian independence, he commanded Ambala in the rank of group captain. In 1949, he was promoted to the rank of Air Commodore and took over as Air Officer Commanding, that is AOC, of an operational command, which later comes to be known as the Western Air Command. Now, basically, these are the achievements in field of this Air Force. Passage number 7. Singh had the distinction of having the longest tenure as AOC of an operational base, initially from 1949 to 1952, and then again from 1957 to 1961. After this promotion, after his promotion to the rank of Air Vice Marshal, he was appointed as a AOC in C of Operational Command. AOC in charge. Now again, this is you can say furthermore achievements in this field of Air Force. Towards the end of the 1962 war, he was appointed as a Deputy Chief of the Air Staff and he became the Vice Chief of the Air Staff in 1963. 1965 मध्ये त्यांची डेप्युटीशिप म्हणून नियुक्ती झाली व त्यानंतर 1963 मध्ये एअर स्टाफचे वाईसचीफ म्हणून त्यांची नियुक्ती झाली. He was the overall commander of a joint air training exercises Shiksha held between the IAF, RAF and the RAAF. Now IAF means Indian Air Force, RAAF means Royal Air Force and RAAF means Royal Australian Air Force. And this is a training program between three countries, India, UK and Australia. He was the commander of that joint program. We'll see next passage. Passage number 8. On August 1, 1964, in the rank of Air Marshal, the Marshal of the Air Force Arjun Singh took over the wings of IAF. Now, took over rings means take control. At the time of when it was still rebuilding itself and was gearing up the most new challenges. Now, this is a big quality of this leader. That is, he was still learning new things, he was still improving himself. ज्या वेळेला त्यांनी भारतीय एअरफोर्सचे सूत्रे हातामध्ये घेतली त्यावेळेला ते अजून आपल्याला नवीन काय शिकता येईल का, नवीन काय त्याच्या चॅलेंजेस अशो करता येतील का किंवा डिफीट करता येतील का, हे त्यांचा प्रयत्न सुरू होता. सिंग वॉज द फर्स्ट एअर चीफ टू कीप हिज फ्लाइंग करन्सी इन हिज CAS रँक, हॅविंग फ्लोन ओव्हर द 60 डिफरंट टाइप्स ऑफ एअरक्राफ्ट फ्रॉम प्री वर्ल्ड वॉर टू एरा बायप्लेन्स टू द मोर कंटेम्पररी Gants and Vampires, and he was also flown the transport aircraft like Super Constellation. Now in this second passage, various types of aircrafts that he has flown is mentioned. Next passage. In 1965, when Pakistan launched his Operation Grand Slam with an armored thrust targeted at the vital town of Akhnoor. Singh led IAF through the war with courage, determination and professional skill. He inspired IAF to victory despite the constraint imposed on the full scale of use of Air Force to combat the power. Now, constraints means limitations. Now, there were some limitations to use the full power of the Air Force. But still, Arjun Singh managed to win that war situation. This is because of he had some kind of professional skill. Now, in case as a leader, you have to have some technical skill as well as some mental skill and to handle a team. Now he is motivated his troops, his squadron, etc. And that is why the whole crew was had a victory or some kind of positive confidence, you can say, to win that war situation. That is why Arjun Singh was the most important person. Singh was awarded Padma Vibhushan for his astute leadership for the Air Force during the war. Subsequently, in the recognition of Air Force contribution during the war, the rank of CAS was upgraded and Arjun Singh became the first airship marshal of the Indian Air Force. Now, these are the some kind of, you can say, topmost achievements he had got. First, Padma Vibhushan for his astute leadership, that is you can say unique or you can say extraordinary skill for leadership. And then first airship marshal, that is the topmost position of Indian Air Force, airship marshal he has got. Last passage, he remained a flyer to the end of his tenure in the IAF. Now tenure means time period. Visiting forward bases and units and flying with the squadrons. He retired in August 1969, thereupon accepting ambassadorship to Switzerland. He was a lieutenant governor of Delhi from December 1989 to December 1990. Now, after the retirement, there are some kind of few achievements he has won, which is mentioned here. Having been a source of inspiration to all the personnel of armed forces through the years, the government conferred the rank of the Marshal of the Air Force upon Arjun Singh in January 2002, making him the first and the only 5-star rank officer with the Indian Air Force. But again, this is the topmost achievement he has got in 2002, that is equivalent to 5-star rank officer with the Indian Air Force. Okay, with this we end up with this topic. If you have any doubts or queries, please send message or email us. You will get the PDF file of this 1.3 on Wings of Fire topic. Solve the questions in your notebook as per the given in assignment PDF file. Thank you so much.